Welcome. I'm Kristen, and I am with the Math and Science Center of Girl Scouts of Central Indiana. Today, we are here to do another virtual fun challenge. And today, we're going to do putting into engineering, where we're going to learn a little bit more about how engineers go through designing things, as well as making our very own putt-putt golf course. So, the first step in being an engineer is deciding on what our problem is. So, sometimes those problems can be really, really difficult and a little bit more challenging, but sometimes they can be as simple as, I'm bored. What can I do to not be so bored today? And I'm gonna go ahead and help you out with that, and we're gonna design a putt-putt golf course today. That's gonna be our problem, is we're bored and we wanna design a golf course to make sure that we're having a little bit of fun. The second step is called brainstorming and research. And I have and or. Sometimes engineers do both. Sometimes they mainly just do brainstorming. It just depends. So today, if you aren't very comfortable with understanding what a putt-putt golf course could look like, and you need a little bit of inspiration, or you need to get some ideas, you might want to take a few minutes to do some research online to get some other ideas of what other putt-putt courses might look like, some of the obstacles they might have, some of the different fun features that they have that you might want to incorporate into your own design. Once you feel like you're in a good spot, then you go ahead and move straight into brainstorming. And brainstorming, I think, is always the most fun. And that's where the engineers just go and start writing down ideas or typing out ideas, either one. And if you are a sketcher, you can also draw out your ideas too. But basically you're going through and you're just like listing out everything that you could possibly do. And then you start moving forward into some of those designs. So before I started the video, I did my own little brainstorming session. And I actually started with just trying to think of things that I was interested in that I might have more fun trying to create a theme from. So I was writing things down like Gecko Land and candy, because everyone loves candy. I'm into animals, so I also went with like an elephant theme, and I also like to read, so I put down maybe a book theme. But as I was like mulling things over in my head, I really wanted to move into that gecko theme. So I started sketching out some different ideas, thinking about what geckos usually like or where they live or what's associated with them. So I was writing things down like, you know, I could have like a sand obstacle or add some water or rocks in there. And with rocks, maybe I could hit a golf ball into like this little rock cave and then it come out into the other side to try to make my hole in one. I was also trying to think about things like making out some different ideas for my overall golf course that associated with geckos. So for me, like here would be my starting spot, and then I have to make it into my my hole. And so I was thinking, well, maybe I could make an obstacle out of like gecko tails, and they have to like weave in and out. And then if that's a little weird, then maybe a second choice could be that the tails are curled over and I have to get the ball underneath and through the gecko tails. I was thinking that maybe like a final course would be where I have to get through some rock obstacles, and then the final piece would be where I have to like shoot it into an open gecko mouth, and that would be the final hole for my course. So just writing down lots of different ideas. Some geckos are nocturnal, so maybe making like a glow in the dark feature. They love to eat bugs. I could incorporate that. I was even thinking about my club that I would use. So once you feel like you have some good ideas, don't worry, you can always add more. That's just to get us initially going and to understand where we're gonna build from. The next thing is to do your prototype. So your prototype is where you're actually going to get things to start building your putt-putt golf course. Now you can make this as small or as big as you would like. You can use things around your house. Shoe boxes are fantastic. If you need to, you can get a parent to kind of help cut that down so it's not so high. You can incorporate some of the cardboard from shoe boxes into your design. You can use anything that you might find laying around your house, like twine, tape, markers. You know, we might find some popsicle sticks that we can use to build bridges or other obstacles. I found some of this crinkly paper from another activity that we did, and I can incorporate that into my design. And then I'm just gonna start building. So I'm gonna leave that up to you guys. Did wanna show one little thing. So remember how I said I might try to do a different club? So using pipe cleaners, I actually made a couple little golf clubs and I tried to make them look like little gecko feet. So it has its little toes and I decided to bend it. And so obviously if this is the size of my club, I'm gonna have to make my golf course, my putt-putt course a little bit smaller. So a shoebox would be perfect. And then I was thinking I would use like a little pom-pom ball and use that as my golf ball to go ahead and hit around the golf course or the putt-putt course. So last but not least, once you guys have designed and built your very own putt-putt golf course, of course, the final step is to share your results, which is exactly what engineers do too. If they decide that they have something that's working, they don't want to keep that just to themselves. They want to share out and have other people give them feedback. And then they might actually go back and retweak some of their stuff. They might start all over, or they might just go back in and add some other design elements. But go ahead and share your results with your friends and your family. And go ahead and even take some pictures and send to Girl Scouts of Central Indiana. We would love to see some of your putt-putt golf course design ideas. So with that, that is your challenge for the week. I'd like to go ahead and add on an additional piece. If you are brownies or daisies, I'm gonna challenge you to try to do 1 to 2 courses. If you are juniors or cadets, I'm gonna push you guys to do a few more and let's shoot for 3 or 4. And then finally, if you are a senior or cadet, we're going for 9. We're going for like half course and everything. So you can have a lot of fun with the themes, with the obstacles, let your imagination go crazy. And again, we wanted to see some of those fun pictures. Share them with your friends and your family. Enjoy your summer and be sure to come back next week for another virtual fun challenge. Have a great day.